Hallelujah, glory to God. Good morning, everybody. Trust we are doing well. Thank you so much for the prayers, the calls. The prayers of saints is really, really amazing. You know, how the Lord strengthens us all and all. Before I go into what we would look at today, I want to take a moment to, I want to play a song and would proceed from there. Yesterday, for those that don't know, I lost my spiritual father on Monday, right? And it feels like my dad dying again. But God is faithful. God is faithful. And as we navigate, just keep us as a church, as a people, as we navigate this season. But we were about to pray yesterday. First, for those of you that came to Recalibrate Conference or you watched, there was a Pastor Femi Adun session. One thing is certain, God does, for a believer, God doesn't just drop things like that. It is either littering our path, you know. I personally had elongated weariness from Friday or Thursday, but I kept praying till you have a note of victory, you know. But that message by Apostle Femi, talking about transition, he kept saying, this is the word I have to the church. He said, I'm not here for anything. Like, you know what, you find yourself there, and just kept saying, this is the word I have to the church. And he said, there's a transition coming, something is coming, you know. And to be honest, I'm interpreting it as different things, because a lot of things have happened since then, but we give God praise. And as we're praying yesterday, Aka asked the question. We're about to pray, and just whilst it was about to start, I said, what Pastor Ty would do? And immediately, you know, I just remembered so many things. And I was just going through a lot of memories. I was speaking with Pastor Christine. First, at the point where I got the message, we're having the conversation. Different people reach out to me at the same time for whatever random reasons. And from how are you? Somebody called and said, I just wanted to hear your voice. And I found out strange. In fact, I thought the person knew. And I just, you know, kept quiet. But, you know, but it's just amazing how God will never leave us comfortless. Anyways, so we're praying. And I said, what will Pastor do? Number one, Pastor is going to be jumping and singing and rejoicing. When he lost his first wife, he said, it was said as he broke the news, he went down on his knees and worshiped. That's one of the things that impacted even our current president. Like, what's this, you know? The second one, the same thing. We see him leading, you know, and okay, maybe I should read the scripture. Hebrews 11, then we'll end with the song. Hebrews 11 comes to mind. You know, a lot of times I think for our generation, the way we explain this is a lesson to everyone, not because of death or whatever, but the way we think God gets his glory from our lives can be very different from how he really is getting glory from our life. I wish I could repost every tweet. I wish I could repost every... I'm trying to keep up with, you know, and the devil failed. He thought it was going to crumble us, but he's birthing in us a greater weight of glory and faith. I'm just seeing how a man's life can, I mean, people have died, and I mean no disrespect, people have died. In fact, there's one older American general that died like a month or less than 2 months ago that I shared with you what happened and what is happening now. And I'm just like, listen, man, even the title is not enough. It's not what will confer to you honor. To be honest, everybody going about fighting honor is what you really do for God and how you really love the people God has brought your way that will make lasting impact, you know. So let's go to, you know, we talk about the hallmark of faith a lot. We like the Abraham faith. We like the David, you know, we like the Moses kind of faith and all of those things. All right, so let's go from there. From 35, faithful women saw their dead children raised in resurrection. No, 36, talking about faith. Others were mocked and experienced the most severe beating with whips. This is the same scripture, the same place we're talking about others that got results. So at the end of the day, results means different things. The way God judges results, while we might not have control of what it looks like, but the question is, will our names be written this way? So others were mocked and experienced the most severe beating with whips. They were in chains and in prison. These fake champions were brutally killed by stoning, being sawed in two, or slaughtered by the sword. These lived in faith as they went about wearing goat skin and sheep skin for clothing. They lost everything they possessed. They endured great afflictions and they were cruelly mistreated. They wandered the earth, living in deserted wilderness, in caves, on barren mountains, in the holes in the earth. Truly, the world was not even worthy of them, not realizing who they were. Some of us don't even know them. I wrote them in my book. So we don't even know them. Like, I was sharing with a friend of mine, Pastor Bri and I were praying this morning because we were praying together for a bit. And he said, when I was sharing the scripture, the Lord said, he said, this scripture was the exact scripture God gave to him. Like, we don't even know them. So they could name some that you knew. These ones, they're a category of people, meaning they were even much more than the ones that you know, right? He said, these were the true heroes. Can you imagine? These were the true heroes, commended for their faith, yet they lived in hope without receiving the fullness of what was promised. But now God has invited us to live in something much better than they had, faithfulness. This is so that they could be brought to finished perfection alongside us. As for us, we have all these great witnesses, those of us left on earth, who encircle us like clouds. So we must let go of every wound that has pierced us and sin we so easily fall into. Then we'll be able to run life's marathon race with passion and determination. For the path has already been marked for us. We look away from the natural realm and fasten our gaze onto Jesus, who birthed faith within us and lead us towards forward in faith's perfection. His example is this: because his heart was focused on the joy of knowing that he would be the ease, he endured the agony of the cross, conquered his humiliation, and now sit exalted at the right hand of the throne of God. So consider carefully how Jesus faced such intense opposition from sinners who oppose their own souls so that you won't become worn down and cave in pressure. So what's God saying to us this morning? That you see, as you go through life, as we navigate all of this, as we, number one, don't even get into the place of, oh God, you know? I mean, we have those moments where, like, God, I was like, Holy Spirit, you just have to help me. There were thoughts, there were questions, and not. And in his faithfulness, he gave answers. But the greatest thing the Lord would give us is the strength that cannot be explained. You know, that's the beautiful thing. I saw it happen with my dad. I've seen it happen again. And it's just some things where you navigate things and you can't explain where the strength, where the joy, where the peace, and the tenacity to even pursue. I feel like I'm privileged to, I don't just have to read about Job. I've seen a man, you know, from his 49th year, thereabout, literally fought through, you know, always in faith. Remember one of the conversations we had, Pastor would say things like, you know, if this is how God wants to get his glory, so let it be. I saw a video clip yesterday, somebody brought it up where he was saying to God that, oh, he was saying to people that I would never, that's why I don't condone self-pity. Because that would be an insult to the Holy Spirit. He said, some of you might think, with everything you've been through, he said, yes. He said, because he knows that he's a special breed in the hands of God. You know, when you are able, a soldier, I don't know how many of you have watched medieval movies that despite being afflicted, they will stand still. It's only coward soldiers that run, they will stand. They go into the battle. And for me, there's so many lessons learned. Another thing is just make memories with people. You don't never can tell. So all those people that you're saying you love them, you let them know. All those people that you are waiting till you have billion to bless them. I think the Lord gave me a chance to, you know, again with this, you know, my dad passed, and there were some things I wanted to do. Still some things I wish I did as well for passports. I'm grateful to God I have an opportunity to do the things I could do. You know, I didn't mind my words of affection. I remember one of the calls he had, and, you know, he was sharing some things with me. I didn't miss out on learning, sitting down, asking all the questions I could. I didn't miss out on just expressing my heart. I didn't miss out. And I just want us to live fully that way. Go out there, love, live, pursue the dream, live like your life, build a legacy. And the greatest joy is that we're part of a legacy that is bigger than us. And if the legacy of Christ was not stopped because of his death, I am so certain that this legacy of Christ through his son, Pastor Taiwo Odukaya, will not stop. Moving on, the entire family looked like they were martyred for the sake of the gospel. They all died in the line of duty, just doing the work, at least the parents, doing the work of God. So what is our response as a church? Pray for the family, especially the two little boys. Pray for the, all of them, to be honest. Pray for the family. Pray for the church. Sounding this way, I still have my moments. I'll cry. I'll remember. I'll smile. But there is this strength. There is this joy. And that's why I also understand the power of the prayer of the saints. So the question is, what will your life be known for? What will you be known for? Are we still negotiating? Oh God, how far can I go? This is like a wake-up call. Sometimes we're so comfortable on earth thinking that this is home. You know, what is funny, because he's in a better place. One, he made it. we are the one that needs to live our life with fear and trembling and know God, I beg you. You know, that kind of thing. You know, I just want to imagine what will it be like. I was singing the song yesterday and they were laughing. I mean, my husband was like, yeah, just stop this song you're singing. Like, I can only imagine what would it be like surrounded by his glory. What will his eyes be? Will he dance before God? Will he sing the song together? Look at what the scripture says about Hebrews 11. And I'm just like, God. And someone said, he has modeled so much, so much of how the work goes on. In spite of our pain. And it's funny because the message of Bill Johnson I listened to on Monday was talking about, they just lost somebody at that point. I don't think it was his wife then. They went through a very tough time, their family. I think somebody died, their sister died, somebody just death. And Bill was still talking about how you have to, in all your ways, acknowledge him and it will direct your path. Meaning even this one, even this pain, even this grief, even this, you will have to acknowledge him. You have to do it with him. You know, for a long time, when you say, prepare the table for you in presence of your enemy, your heads run with oil. Sometimes we're thinking about just, because you have all those things, not prepared, we are not eating. No, sometimes you are going through tough time and the enemy is watching. We are right there at the table. Don't leave the table. Don't get up off the table. One of the things the devil tries to do with this is that, Jack, I've seen, thank God, just one or two, really. It's not, I've seen more testimonies of faith and all, but people are like, oh my God, how can he save God this way? And I just realized that there is a group of believers that we don't even understand this Hebrews 11. It's like we stop at Abraham, right? It's like, that's a wake-up call. The Christianity that talks about preservation of your life. No, your life is hid in Christ. Your life is secured in Christ. So we will keep marching on. We will keep doing what God has called us to do. In pain, in fear, in faith, regardless, we keep marching on. We keep moving on. We're going to have a great time at Wearing Friends for Abuja. We're going to have a great time in service of church. Wearing Friends of Showers will keep moving on. Things will keep moving on. We know why? Because we are all playing our part for the greater good. So the question again is, what will our lives be known for? What would we be known for? Are you able to create those memories with your children right now? Are you able to explain that life with your loved ones? Are you able to do those things? You know, some of us are so busy. Are you able to make time for that coffee or with that person you really love? Are you able to, bless them? You know, sometimes I tell people, we are waiting for when you have all the grandeur of the wealth. My beloved father in the Lord is gone. His beautiful clothes ain't going. His bank account is here. The church he served is here. The title ain't going. Like everything, what is going with him is what he has done truly with his life, with his resources. He's going there to see the walk. And that scripture in Revelation said, you do not deny my name. The strength of faith. He did not deny the name of God. Not once did he even, he was always forward. Like whether his eyes were shot red, he's weeping from his death of his wife. He has many times. I've even asked him a lot of times, how do you do this? I'll tell you that, I don't know. I feel like God just helps his heart. God gladdens his heart. You know, joy just living out. You know, how are you a leader that despite the fact that you lead a massive global movement? Like the beautiful thing about Founders, Founders is just an apostolic church, not about the members. You know, I'm seeing testimony of people that were picked from public school that he paid their school fees. I've seen crazy testimonies across board. And you're just seeing how, regardless of his title or what, a big church, but everybody feels like they have a personal, even those I've never met him one-on-one, through our lives, through the lives of the people he has raised, people are able to experience the grace of God. So don't joke with legacy. Don't joke with whatever God has put in your life to build. Don't joke whatever God gives you opportunity to be part of, because you never can tell what your impact will bring to the table. So we're going to thank God. But I'm going to just play a song and then we'll just thank God. Please, if you indulge me, just thank God for the life of mine. I have no doubts that my understanding of the move of the Spirit, my life is completely, my story is incomplete without the impact of that man, the words, the prayer, the random, do you see this? And, you know, I give God praise for that, you know. So I'm just going to play the song now and we'll just worship wherever you are and just trust God. Amen.
Solid ground, firm through the fiercest droughts and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. Every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. till he returns. Oh, calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
Oh, we just thank you. Can we just unmute our mics if we can? And please just join me as we thank God for the life of Pastor Taiwo Adekoya. And let's pray for the Fountain of Life Church. The Lord will give us strength as we navigate this and we'll remain united. Can we just open our mouths and begin to pray wherever we are, please? Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord, for the life of your Son.
Thank you for the gift of this man to the body. Thank you, Jesus, for what you did. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you for our Father Ibrahim. Thank you for the Fountain of Life Church. Thank you, O God, for the seed of greatness. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for what you've done. Thank you for where it's hard. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for what you're set to do. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for his life. Thank you for the legacy you have built through him. Thank you, oh God, for all the sons and daughters you have used him to raise. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. 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 Oh, Lord, we give you all the praise. Lord, we give you all the glory, honor, and adoration. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Oh, we're grateful. 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 We're grateful, God. We're grateful. We're grateful for the impact. Thank you for the legacy continues. We lift up the Fountain of Life Church into your hands, oh God. We pray that, Lord, your grace will continue with the church. We thank you for unity. Thank you for strength. Thank you for comfort, oh God. Lord, I pray your comfort, oh God. The devil will not hijack this moment or anyone at all. In the name of Jesus, oh God, you will build your church and the gate of hell will not prevail. You will build the Fountain of Life Church and the gate of hell will not prevail. You will strengthen Fountain. You will strengthen all the pastors. You will strengthen all the leaders. You will strengthen all the members. You will strengthen everyone connected, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray for his children. Pray for Pastor Tolu. Pray for Pastor Jimmy. Pray for Pastor Toby. Pray for Jomilo Ju. Pray for all the children and the other boy. Pray for all of them. We pray in the name of Jesus. They are strengthened. I pray for his siblings. I pray for everyone connected to him, oh God. I pray that you strengthen them in inner mind. You strengthen them in the name of Jesus, God. And the devil will have no say in this, oh God. The Lord that the blessings, oh God, you will use this for your glory. Mighty things will come out of this. Lives will be changed. Lives will be born. Lives will be transformed. In the name of Jesus, oh God. Makasu pradana vashikata prado kosha pradana mandekele bokosha taba rendete bokosha mandeke supradaba suprede eshatalaba prado kosu koto rendete. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your unity, oh God. Mashatawa. We are seen, oh God, living victoriously for you. Strength, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. Your name is glorified. Your name is exalted. Your name is exalted. Your name is glorified. In the name of Jesus, Makasata Bayada, Mendeke Shekete Bayada, Jatalaba Kusekete, Adoko. Oh, thank you for testimonies. Thank you for healing. Thank you, Jesus, oh God. Thank you for healing on your wings, oh God. Thank you for healing on your wings, oh God. Thank you for testimonies. Thank you for changed life. Thank you, oh God, for your faithfulness. Thank you because you help us through this. Oh, we are coming out strong. We are coming out strong. We are coming out like a phoenix, We will rise. We will rise like a phoenix will rise in the name of Jesus. We will go forward. We will march forward in the name of Jesus, oh God. We will not relent in this race, oh God. And I prayed for us that left, oh God. We find the strength to press on in the name of Jesus. We find the courage to push in the name of Jesus. Our lives will be a lasting fruit in the name of Jesus. Our lives will be a lasting fruit. Our lives will be a great and lasting fruit in the name of Jesus. From glory to glory, from glory to glory, from strength to strength in the name of Jesus. They will get your hands off Fountain of Life Church. We will not be like child. Our unity will be intact in the name of Jesus. Hey, Makasa Kaya Dabasha. Testimony that your God is marching on in the name of Jesus. His life is death for many more to Christ in his life. In the name of Jesus, many will come to the knowledge of Christ Jesus. Many will come to know him. In the name of Jesus, In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. And this song will struck my spirit again. Our joy has come in the name of Jesus. We love you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
We will not be shaken.
Thank you, Jesus.
We will not be moved.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
For the Lord is beside us. Can we climb our
moon? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
The shadows surround us.
Thank you, Jesus.
We will fear no evil.
Thank you, Jesus.
We'll trust in the Lord with our hearts and in your joy. We will dwell forever.
Y'all ready to go, Columbia?
Thank you, Jesus.
Let's go!
Though the night may makes you weary. Joy is coming, coming, coming in the morning. All praise you, Jesus. I know joy is coming. Yes, joy is coming.
Everybody clap. Yo, hey, everybody clap. Yo, hey. If you know that joy is here tonight, let's raise it again.
We will not be shaken.
Say we will not be moved. For the Lord is beside us. Hey. With him we can. Though the shadows surround us, we will feel no evil. But this will be our response. We're gonna trust in the Lord. Come on, let's raise it together. Say, though the night
may seem
gray, joy is coming, coming.
Joy is coming, coming, coming.
All praise to
all
King
praise
Jesus. Cause
I know joy is
coming. Come on, if you know that joy is here. Say, though the night may
seem gray,
joy is coming, coming.
And bring our joy to light.
We won't submit to sorrow. Our joy is coming in the morning. In the morning. Can we make this confession tonight, Columbia? Say your light.
Your light can drown our darkness and bring our joy.
We won't submit, no. Depression, you gotta get out of here tonight. Low self-esteem, you gotta get out of here tonight. Because joy is here.
In the morning.
Your light can drown and bring our joy
tonight.
We won't submit to sorrow. Hey,
our joy is coming.
Anybody believe that your joy is here tonight? It's coming in the morning. Come on, one more time, raise it with us. Say, so
your light can drown
and bring our joy. We won't submit. We have this promise that joy is coming, and we trust you for it today, God. It's coming in the morning.
Though the night may seem weary, joy is coming, coming, coming in the morning. All praise to King Jesus.
Cause I know joy is
coming.
Do you believe it? Do you believe it?
Since though the night may
have a great day, and remember, if I use this link to join other watches by 9,
press
36 9123, and we're back again in Jesus' name. God bless you all. Let's keep shining and keep moving in Jesus' name. Amen.